game in his honour. That was arranged as part of Mowbray's transfer deal last year. There was some minor crowd trouble, but it failed to spoil Mogger's big day.
Mowbray's return to Middlesbrough attracted a massive Sunday lunchtime crowd to Ayresome Park. 10,000 fanatical Celtic fans travelled down from Scotland. A further 10,000 Boro fans turned up to honour their former inspirational captain. It was also a chance for a first look at their Premier League team and the summer signing Tommy Wright. Boro were on top in the first half, but Celtic were dangerous on the break. A header by Kernaghan was one of Boro's best early chances. Their goal came on the brink of half-time. Willie Faulkner broke through the middle and passed to last season's top scorer, Paul Wilkinson, who made no mistake. The friendly spirit evaporated at half-time with dozens of Celtic fans spilling onto the pitch. The police described it as a minor incident. There were no arrests, but two people were thrown out of the ground before the action could start again. The match finished at 1-1. Even though the incident at half-time had threatened to overshadow the game, the day still belonged to Tony Mowbray, idolised by his current and former fans.
It was, I don't know, it was an emotional day, wasn't it? I mean, to come out and to see so many fans from Glasgow travel down and then so many fans from Middlesbrough turn out, to see the old gate as full as it was, and South Stand and North Stand, you know, packed. It was great to see it, yeah.
Any regrets now about leaving?
No, there's no regrets. I mean, the reasons I left are well catalogued now. It was just a motivation thing, really, why I left. There was no fallout with the club, no lack of feeling for it. That's going to be with me forever.
The new football season begins in less than 3 weeks. With England's elite clubs due to visit Ayresome Park, yesterday was a useful dress rehearsal for the team, the police and the ground authorities. No doubt lessons have been learnt on and off the pitch.